I hand over the keys to the chairman.
According to the Wikwe district chairperson, Jimmy Kanabi, they have tried to extend safe and clean water to most of the villages in the district with the aim of reducing the spread of diseases caused by untreated and unsafe lake water.
So far, Wikwe district, when it comes to water coverage, we are moving on very well, because even this side, of which is kind of deeper, at least you have tried to extend water to other people, not to take or to use water from the lake direct, because it has a lot of issues whereby people can easily be caught with a lot of diseases like bilharzia, typhoid. So that is the major reason why we are extending water.
The Chigugo commissioned water project was upgraded from 19 to 50 solar panels, and the storage was increased from 10 cubic meters to 30 cubic meters, with a total water pipeline of over 10 kilometers. The project is serving over 2,300 families.
Basically, we are able to reach about 2,300 people with this project, for those who can access. And I believe as the district hands over, we shall get more private connections, because the project still has capacity to serve even with private connections. And I think that's the brief. So today we are here for the technical handover of this particular upgrade.
Mayor Feston, the contractor of Chigugo Water Project, explained that they installed 8 new water taps and they're all functioning properly. He commended the district leadership for cooperating with the company.
It has been accomplished successfully. Today we have handed over, and even the 8 taps are working very well. So we thank the embassy of Iceland, we thank the district team, both technical and political, who helped us actually with the challenge of land, especially Chairman 5. We also thank all the community members for the support they gave us to see that we accomplished this project. We thank the district, we thank the embassy, and we still ask for more opportunities to do more works.
Engineer Arthur Kayaga, the Wikwe Water Officer, explained that access to clean and safe water in Wikwe is at 64% and the rural water cover is at 76%. He says they are targeting to cover at least 85% by 2030. He further asked the locals to embrace the use of safe and clean water, which the Iceland Embassy and the district has installed in the area.
Move away from the unsafe water on their lake, so that they can improve their health. But also, by embracing the new system, it means a collective, as a community, they all take responsibility of looking after the system and ensuring that the system remains functional at all times, so that people have access to safe and clean water at all times.
Leaders commended the Iceland Embassy for the donations and developments they have given to the people of Wikwe. They have asked the beneficiaries to make good use of the water system.
We are really grateful. You've heard from the leaders. This is a community that really had challenges. They had so many diseases resulting from taking unsafe clean water. But the expansion has really made a positive impact. There is a reduction in disease prevalence because of the safe water that they are consuming. But this is courtesy of the support from the Embassy of Iceland.
Jimmy Kanabi, the Wikwe district chairperson, noted that the district has 2 major other water extension projects which are about to be commissioned.
The percentage in Wikwe, the coverage of water, we are almost at 40%. But we still have another project which we are going to take in a hand over to the community.
Report compiled by Emmanuel Balukusa for the news.